hi everybody. Welcome to Memorial Stadium in Austin. And as always, it is a big game for the University of Texas and Texas Tech on this day. Well, Texas with the ball first. That was Peter Gardner scrambling and loses six. On the next play, he stays on his feet and gains eight before he goes out of bounds. And the Longhorns have to punt the football. Well, first and 10 from the Tech 14. Robert Hall at quarterback, still playing for the injured Jamie Gill. He finds Lloyd Hill in the flat, and Lloyd gains five. But Tech has to punt, and here is Mark Bounds. He averaged 48 on the day, 78 yards on this punt, and obviously no return. Texas will take the ball on their 20. This will be Phil Brown from Commerce, Texas. He goes over left guard and gains 15 before he's pulled down by Donnie Brooks. Four plays later, Peter Gardere looks to pass. Screenplay out to Childers. He's tackled by Brian Dubisky. And Brian had 12 tackles on the day. Show you a replay. And look at this defense. What a brilliant day the Texas Tech defense had as they really flew around. Well, four plays later, Texas has to punt. McClanahan, who had a miserable day punting the ball, kicks all of 27 yards on this play. Texas Tech sets up shop at the 26. Robert Hall at quarterback. Screen pass to big Anthony McDowell. The senior gets 13 yards and a first down for the Red Raiders. Let's move two plays later. Second and three from the 46. Look at big Anthony breaking tackles. Heads to the sidelines. When all is said and done, he has 22 yards. Show you a replay and look at Anthony as he has great yardage on this play. Hey, that was a face mask, but it was not called. Four plays later, the drive stalls. Senior Lynn Elliott comes in, 48 yards high and good. And Texas Tech, seven plays, 43 yards, up 3-0 over UT. Well, after the kickoff, Gardier wants to throw, but he's in worlds of trouble. Show you a replay. And look at Mike Lissio coming from the far side and chases him down and pulls him down after a short gain. Two plays later, Gardere looking to pass. Wow, Fred Petty comes through untouched. Show you a replay on that. Look how fast. Big Fred, who had seven tackles on the day, and a great one and a little dance right there. UT had to punt the ball. Let's pick it up on second down. Hall carries for a minus three. Boy, you talk about a defensive struggle. This was one in the first half. Texas leading the conference, but I'll guarantee you Texas Tech matched them punch for punch, especially in the first half. There was Mark Bounds getting away another great punt. That was 50 yards and super defensive play right there by Kirby Adams. On the first play for UT, James Hadnott, two-yard gain before Brian Dubisky smacks him down. Second and eight, Hadnott tripped up by Steve Hoffman, number 74. Show you a replay. Good play by Steve as he continues to battle his way to get playing time in that Tech defensive lineup. Well, that's the end of the first quarter. The Raiders up 3-0. First and 10 from the 33, Bam Morris. Well, he has a way of moving the pile, doesn't he? And he gains 11 yards there. Two plays later, the drive will stall as Anthony McDowell goes into trouble, loses one, and Tech has to punt and give the ball up. Let's move it to first and 10 from the 38. Gardere incomplete. No, it's intercepted. Number 17 on the career for Tracy Soule as the junior from Idaloo continues to do brilliant things. And I'll tell you, Tracy brought that one back 30 yards and set Tech up again in great, great shape. Second and from the 24, that's Robert in trouble, and he's finally pushed down. And then Bam, with a couple of horns all over him, gains eight. And on fourth and 15, well, Mark Bounds has to punt again. He does into a strong win, 34 yards. And Ron Kavnis came up with the football again. Looked like Kirby Adams on the defensive play. Back to defense for Tech. Adrian Walker sweeps right. Matt Wingo, who had 11 defensive stops on the day, comes up with that play. And on the very next play, a sweep left this time. Brian Dubisky comes up with a big play. Four plays later, third and seven. Gardere wants to throw, and it's incomplete. Show you a replay. Anthony Wiley with a great play here. Thought the ball was complete, but Anthony stayed with him, took the ball out, and thought it might be a fumble, but they ruled it incomplete. So Texas has to punt the ball. McClanahan, a 45-yarder, and what's this? Tracy Saul on the return, and what a great one. 56 yards here. He had 224 yards in kick returns on the day. What a brilliant day for Tracy Saul. First and 10, Bam Morris into the line. He gained 7. Let's move it down 2 plays later. Anthony McDowell takes the option right, gets 9 yards when all is said and done. And a first play, show you a replay. He got the first down, we should say. There's Anthony behind his offensive line blocking, hurdles an offensive lineman, and picks up 9. Let's move it 2 plays later. Robert Hall trying for the touchdown, throws to Lloyd Hill. Touchdown, no! They rule he is out of bounds. And oh my, I'll tell you, Tech just cannot get the ball in the end zone. Well, Lynn Elliott tries a field goal, 36 yard. Would you believe it is no good? So it remains 3-0 Tech. Gardier comes back on the first play from scrimmage, 39 yards as he completes the ball to Neal, defended by Tracy Saul. 3 plays later, Gardier, screen pass to Walker, and he's going to lose 1. There's Ben Kirkpatrick on the great defensive play. Well, UT had to punt. Tech takes over, a minute left in the first half. Bam Morris gets 4, and now watch this play. Texas Tech has outplayed UT all the first half, but a fumble. Robert Hall coughed it up. Show you a replay. He was stripped right there. The ball comes free, and let's call on that Tech defense. On the first play from scrimmage, Adrian Walker tries the right side, no gain. Great swarming defense. On the next play, Walker again tries, no, and he can't get in. Texas calls a timeout. Carlos Maynard, the defensive coordinator, calls his team together and sets them up. That makes it 3rd and goal into the end zone. UT finally scores, and so just like that, 1:03 left in the half, Texas leads it 7-3. Well, you think Tech laid down and died? Try again. This is Rodney Blackshear. He'll return the kickoff 31 yards, and what an offensive weapon Rodney Blackshear is. On the first play, Hall throws to Anthony Stinnett. Great catch over there on the far sideline. First down. That after a gain of 14. Let's move it along. Robert Hall scrambling, and he pushes his blocker out of the way, and he's off to the races, the 40, the 30, inside the 20, at the 15, the 10, pull down at the 9-yard line. Well, Tech knocking on the door again. Show you that replay, and Robert really adds a great dimension to that Red Raider offense. Thought he might score again. You remember against Rice, he had that long touchdown run. Well, Tech in great position. Robert now going for the end zone. Just a few seconds left. Throws for Lloyd Hill. Ball broken up and dropped. Robert trying again into the end zone, looking for Hill. Wow! Lloyd was really smacked, but he came back. One more time. Robert into the end zone, throwing intended for Byron Hooper. Can't handle it. And so Tech still unable to get the ball in the end zone. Lynn Elliott comes in. No time left on the clock when the ball's in the air. It's good. So it is Texas 7, Texas Tech 6. At the half, let's hear the going band from Raiderland.
Thank you.
Welcome back. Some 12,000 Red Raider fans on hand to watch this one. And in the second half, it's going to be a real thriller of a ball game. UT comes out, and that was guarded here for Thrift. Good for 22 yards on the next play. Wow. Sean Jackson knocks Gardier down for a loss of 5. On the next play, Gardier wants to throw, looks, does, ball is up, and intercepted, Tracy Saul. That is his 18th career interception, breaking the school record set by Elmer Tarbox. Well, on the sidelines, the coaches, this time Ted Unbehagen, try to get their troops all together. Let's move it down later in the third quarter, and Robert Hall finds Rodney Blackshear, and what a catch, 46-yard gain. Here's another look at it. He fooled me with the camera, but look at Rodney. Wow, what a catch. And Texas Tech is set up. That will be down at the 2-yard line. They'll make it the 5-yard line. Two plays later, here's a trick play. Anthony Lynn throwing to Anthony McDowell, his first touchdown of his Texas Tech career. There's a replay. Anthony Lynn said it wasn't pretty, but it was effective. And so the Red Raiders, after Lynn Elliott's extra point, have jumped back up on top in this ball game. And there you see some of the Red Raider fans down in the end zone. Tech 12, Texas 7. Let's move down further in the third quarter. Gardner at quarterback, he fumbles, and Harry Dias comes up with it for the Red Raiders, and boy, it looks good for us, doesn't it? Robert Hall now on the second play from scrimmage, throws, and it is intercepted. And so the Red Raiders fail to capitalize one more time. Now UT on their best drive of the day. This will be Butch Hadnot. He picks up 9. Three plays later, Gardier fumbles the snap and says, I'll take it myself, runs for his life, and he picks up 6. Two plays later, Gardier, heavy rush, he eludes it, throws over the middle, the ball is going to be complete, 39-yard gain, and the horns are at the 26 on the next play. Hadnot takes the pitch, finds a seam, and goes 26 yards for the touchdown at the end of the third quarter. UT is up 13-12, and we have a barn burner heading into the fourth quarter. UT back with the ball now in the fourth quarter. Hadnot is really smacked. Loss of 3 by Matt Wingo and friends. Third and 8, Gardier is looking to throw, does, ball is bounced up in the air by Donnie Brooks and intercepted by Anthony Wiley. So the Red Raiders are in UT territory. Fourth play of the drive, Robert Hall picks up the first down on the keeper. On the next play, Robert looking to throw, throws in the end zone for Lloyd Hill, broken up. And so Tech comes away with no points again, but Lynn Elliott comes on, 52-yard field goal, high and far and just wide. Show you what a field goal kicker goes through. Here is the attempt, focused on Lynn, and just off to the right, but an excellent try on that one. Well, UT comes up with the football, and the ball is given off up the middle, but boy, what a great play by Harry Dias to stop him for 5. But Tech was offsides, and so two plays later, Hadnot turning the corner. He gains 12, and UT has a first down. Four plays later, 3rd and 5 from the 27. Hadnot breaking free. He'll gain 9, and another first down for Texas. Let's move it 3 plays later. 2nd and 25 after a penalty. Gardier with a great block on the outside will go down the sideline inside the 20 at the 16. Drive stalls. Jason Ziegler comes in. He kicks, and Texas extends that lead to 16-13. Well, let's move it back. Texas has the ball after Tech fails to move. This is Gardier weaving in and out. Now finds an open space. He's off to the races, and before he's pulled down, he has 28 yards. Three plays later, Hadnot goes right, again finds that seam, and he too is off to the races. 34-yard touchdown run, Texas 23, Texas Tech 12. There you see only 4 minutes left in the game. You think it's all over, right? Well, you don't know this Red Raider team. On the kickoff, Ben Kirkpatrick takes the ball for 10 out to the 30. On the second play from scrimmage, Robert Hall finds Byron Hooper. Good. Gain of 7. Two plays later, 3rd and 10 from the 30. Hall to Hill. Complete. Great catch. Gain of 41. On the next play, after an interference call, Robert again looking, throwing down the sideline. There was the interference call. There you saw the hanky. And Tech again is inside the 20. Robert throwing into the end zone, or just short of the end zone. Lloyd Hill can't come up with it. So Lynn Elliott comes in. He hits the field goal. And Texas Tech is pulled with an 8, 23-50. There you see 2 minutes left. The defense does its job. The onside kick right there. Tech fails to come up with it. Now the defense does their job. They hold UT. They have to punt. Tracy Saul gathers it at the 8, tries to return and pull down. 57 seconds left in the game. Tech has the ball at the 13. Robert Hall to pass. It is good, Lloyd Hill. Gain of 37. Clock is ticking now. Very few seconds left in the game. Robert looks, throws, complete. Anthony Stinnett has it for a gain of 22. Make it first and 10 at the 13. Robert wants to throw. Into the end zone for Byron Hooper. Oh, just off his hands. And so there is about 20 seconds left. Robert throws. Ooh, Lloyd Hill can't come up with it. Great try there. One-handed try. Robert again. About 15 seconds left in the game. Throws. Brilliant defense by Kavnis to keep Hooper from coming up with that football. Make it the last play of the drive. Ball over the middle. Incomplete. Pageant fails to come up with it. UT holds on, but a super game by Tech, and as you might suspect, a subdued locker room.
Well, Ed, I think when you lose those kind of ball games, it hurts, no doubt about it. It takes a lot out of you. The guys really played hard. I don't know that I've ever been around a bunch that played any harder than they did today. Played to win and had a lot of opportunities. We just couldn't quite get it done. That really does take a lot out of you. I'm not a moral victory guy. I think that you can stomach it sometimes when you lose and don't play too good. I think you can certainly stomach it when you go lose and you play hard. We played a good team today. Their defense is very good. Their defense made the plays when they had to keep them ahead. Their offense, when they had to, they cranked it up, drove it 98 yards for a touchdown, and you got to give them credit for that. Texas has got a good football team. They're the defending champions in the conference. They got good players, and I compliment them because they did win the game. It is a sad deal, though, and it just takes a lot out of you because our guys really played. We can't play much better than that. We can't play harder than that. We can play better, I guess. But it was, and those things are. That's hard, and that's the difficult part of this crazy business. But I'll tell you, the sun's going to come up tomorrow, and Arkansas's going to be in there next Saturday. And I'm not making light of the fact we lost, but what do you do? What do you say? There's some things we wish we had back, but there's also some things, some great plays out there, and great efforts, and great enthusiasms, and shoot, that's all you can do. And our guys came to Austin, and they came to win. Weren't intimidated by the crowd, hung in there, and we just couldn't quite get it done.
Doubly frustrating because your defense really turned the ball over a lot, and then you couldn't kick it in on offense several times.
Yep, that's the way it is when you're playing against a great defensive football team like Texas. And, our defense played great, and their defense played great. And their offense cranked it up and had a couple of long drives for scores, and ours couldn't quite get it in. We had to settle for a couple of field goals in the course of the game instead of touchdowns. And those threes are a lot different than sevens, and how that works. But that's there were two good defensive football teams out on that field today, I'll tell you.
Well, it was a good day in the kicking game. We had all the guys, Brian Nabisky, Scotty Allen. It's hard to name all of them. They all do such a good job on the returns, and they showed how good of a group they are today by kickoff returns and punt returns both. They all did such a good job blocking.
I believe there's some kind of record that you set today. I mean, I hadn't said anything. What your interception record today for the career? How do you feel about that?
Well, it's I guess it's always kind of nice to get the record, but. That stuff's really not important. Winning football games is what's important, and that's what we're here to do is to win football games, and all that stuff is, it just comes second or third or it just comes way down the line.
We anticipated them, playing us, good defense since the good game we had last year. I compliment the secondary; they came out and did a good job.
Talk a little bit about the offensive attitude right now. You guys played great today. Should have won it, but didn't. What's the attitude right now in the team?
you know, we can't let this, you know, this loss get us down. We have to, you know, bounce back. And for, you know, the receivers, you know, Coach Williams did a good job of getting us ready. We just, you know, didn't come out and execute like we should have.
Talk a little bit about your return that you had. You almost broke it. Two men left, and they got you. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, you know, I knew we had to have a big play to get at least something going, you know. We couldn't down the end zone, start from the 20. We had to get at least closer to the 50 as possible, and I just went through the hole, and Lance Gunn was there to stop me that time.
What's that two on the team right now? You guys played them great. So, are you down, or are you just guys just ready to get on for the next week?
You know, right now it hurts. You know, we felt we could win that game, and we have to go back tomorrow, you know, and look at the film and regroup. You know, we're not going to be down completely, you know, because, you know, like right now, a lot of people don't expect us to be this far, and we're just going to keep on working hard.
You know, they've got a good football team, got a lot of weapons. Maybe just out of position, you know, made a few mistakes, but they found them, and they did a good job. You know, you got to give them some credit.
Talk a little bit about the problems Gardner and Butch Hadnott gave you all.
They did. You know, I thought we shut them down pretty well. They had, you know, had a few good plays. Gardner uncovered around the ends. You know, that's just a problem of containment. But he did a good job. You know, they came ready to play, and a good football team.
Really, the defense, they really had a great game. You guys had a couple of interceptions, a couple of turnovers. Just couldn't capitalize on that. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, it was tough. We did have a great football game. Had a lot of turnovers. I thought we played extremely well. You know, Texas is a good football team, and we knew it coming in. We knew we had to play well. And, you know, it just came down to one of those deals. You know, like I said, Texas is a good football team, but they're not a better football team than we are, and I think that's what makes the loss hurt so bad.
Well, you know, first half we shut them down pretty good, and they came out second half and had not started running a lot better in the second half. You know, they gave him the ball a lot more. He found the weaknesses on our defense, and he you know, just took advantage of them. But you know, this was a great game. You know, this was a great football game to watch, and it's a great game to play. I'll tell you.
I think they had some bad play calling in the first half. They didn't know what they wanted to run, and they came out in the second half and figured it out and figured out what we were doing, and they started running more sweeps, more option stuff like that.
Against the run a week ago, Rice had the nation's leading rusher, and you guys kept Trevor Cobb bottled up. What maybe did Texas do differently that you all had so much trouble stopping when they finally got a roll?
I don't know. I mean, I think maybe we were concentrating on Gardner too much, and then all of a sudden here comes Hadnott. Hadnott's a player that he hadn't been having a good season, but he came out, you know, in the second half and had a great, great half.
Let's talk about a big play that you had down on the second down and goal to go play. You get to limber up the arm a little bit.
No, I didn't get to limber up. It was just kind of play was called, but it was a great, you know, play was called great time. You know, Texas was the hard to score on inside there, running the ball, and we knew we was going to have to do some kind of play action or something, and that was a great call.
You've been working on that play all this season, and I'm sure for several years. It's not something that just happened overnight, but what did Anthony Lynn, what were you thinking when the play was called and you broke the huddle?
I was thinking, well, I got to make this work. I've had 4 years practice.
Describe the play as it developed.
Well, it's just a power back. We're in goal line offense, fullback heading up in the blocking, and power back slipping out into the flats, and I just got to make a great fake, pull up and hit the open guy.
You throw rolling to your left across your body. Quarterbacks have a hard time doing that.
Yeah, you know, it wasn't a real pretty pass, but it got there.
One of the big plays, though, that you do convert, you catch a touchdown pass from Anthony Lynn. Why don't you talk a little bit about that play?
Well, that's a play, you know, we work, you know, we have special pairs of specialties, and that's a play we work on the goal line because, you know, everybody knows when we get to the goal line, sweep is one of our main runs, you know. So, and once we pitch the pass, pitch the ball to Anthony Lynn, everybody bites up, and I just slip off into the flats, and he just threw it over the defender's head.
You said it wasn't that pretty of a pass, but it got the job done. How did it look coming at you?
You know, I really can't remember see it coming at me. All I seen the ball, well, I don't know if it was wobbly or was it a spiral. I don't know. I just seen it coming. I reached up and grabbed it, and that's all I remember.
I guess the key thing about that play is you got to run it in the right place at the right time.
Yeah, you know, Texas probably been working on our sweep the whole week, you know, stop the sweep, you know, and we felt, you know, they're real good pursuing. So we want, you know, we knew that would work against them exactly.
All in all, your impressions of the Texas defense?
You know, they're real tough and they're real big and very physical, you know. And you can't take them away from them. They play an excellent game. And I think, you know, it's probably one of the toughest defense we played, you know, besides A&M.
Tell you what, it's hard to throw sometimes when there's three or four guys bearing down on you. This team kept battling back, though, and even at the very end, you're in a position to get in the end zone. Why don't you talk a little bit about those four pass plays, three of which went into the end zone that looked like any of the three might have been caught.
Yes, I saw one of them to Byron Hooper. That's the only one I saw. Every other pass that I threw, I was, you know, on my back because a good rush by Texas. One to Lloyd, I was on my, you know, my back, so I don't really know the outcome of the play, you know, till I go back and watch the film.
I tell you, Lloyd reached up and almost pulled one in with one hand, but when you let the football go, did you think it was going to be caught for a touchdown?
Yeah, because Lloyd, you know, he's a tall receiver, and usually the DBs he goes against are shorter than him, so any ball that you put up, he's able to grab it.
We missed a couple of field goals in the course of the game that could have been a big difference, too. So there were a lot of chances, a lot of things that might have turned this thing one way or the other. A lot of penalties. We lost our poise a little bit out there, and that's not good. It's a heated contest, and, you know, both teams played real hard, played real fierce, and you just got to keep your poise. And I thought, by and large, really both squads did a fine job of not fighting and all that stuff, but there was, you know, we lacked a little discipline in two or three areas, and we can get that corrected, believe me.
Something really special next Saturday, a chance to get back on the winning track, playing Arkansas maybe for the last time in the foreseeable future.
Yeah, it'd be a lot of fun. I'll tell you, the funny thing about it, we were 1-4 about 4 weeks ago, and it looked bad. Things weren't good. We weren't playing very good, and everybody had their head down a little bit. And these guys really did. They banded together, and they said, let's go try to win these last six and go try to be 7-4. And really worked hard, and they've done everything we've asked them. And, you know, I think we've got a chance to win all the last three. I thought we had a chance to win all four of them. But this is I tell you, I really am proud of our team. And I guess that might sound crazy when you lose and you say that, but I don't know that they could have played any harder than they did today. We broke down on a few plays, and no question about that, but that's the way the ball bounces sometimes. But there were a lot of great plays and great efforts, and hopefully we grew up a lot today, and this team will finish very strong.
I look forward to seeing you next week.
Well, thanks a lot, Ed, and we look forward to being there. I tell you, the Arkansas game will be it'll be a great test. They're leading the conference right now, and I don't know what happened today, but I'm sure they're going to be fired up and ready to go, and we'll respond. We'll answer the bell. We'll play them good, I'll tell you.